The functional assessment-based intervention model employs a systematic approach to designing, implementing, and evaluating functional assessment-based procedures developed by Umbright, Barrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007. This video introduces you to the function matrix, which is utilized in step 2, conducting the functional assessment. The function matrix is a tool used to organize data collected throughout the functional assessment, including data from teacher, parent, and student interviews, as well as from ABC data. Teams input these data onto the function matrix, which includes 6 cells to show the maintaining functions. The columns indicate 2 columns, positive reinforcement, access something, and negative reinforcements, avoiding something, with the rows indicating whether or not the behavior occurs to access or to avoid, attention, tangibles, or activities, and or sensory experiences. This illustration, offered by Germer et al., 2011, illustrates a process developed by Lane and colleagues to directly link interview responses and instances of ABC observation data to the specific cells in the matrix, which aids in the determination and communication of the hypothesized function. Notice when collecting ABC data, each instance of the behavior during the observation are coded by 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3, etc. 1.1 indicates the first observation and the first instance of which the behavior occurred. 1.2 indicates the first observation day and the second instance in which the behavior occurred. And 1.3 indicates the first observation day and the third instance in which behavior occurred, and so forth. As you can see from this functional assessment data now organized in the function matrix, when David is off task, he gets attention from his teacher and peers and does not have to complete assignments. Positive reinforcement, attention, and negative reinforcement, activity. Once teams have completed the function matrix, they can visually analyze the data and determine a hypothesis of the function of the behavior. Using the function matrix, teams can hypothesize whether the student is trying to access or avoid attention, activities, tangibles, and/or sensory experiences. The function matrix provides a systematic method for teams to develop a hypothesis statement on why the challenging behavior occurs, in other words, the function of the student's behavior. To learn more about the function matrix, you may refer to the book Functional Behavior Assessment and Function-Based Intervention, an Effective Practical Approach by Umbright, Farrow, Leopsen, and Lane, 2007.